Now, a lobbyist's view. Past executive director of AIPAC, Morry Amitay. Morry?
Thank you, Seymour. Can I qualify a lobbyist by saying I'd like to speak to you today as a pro-Israel lobbyist, since my focus will be on where the two candidates stand on Israel-related issues. I couldn't quite figure out what a lobbyist's view would be, and particularly given the opprobrium that we now have heaped upon lobbyists, I've recently started calling myself a corridor-ist. I think it sounds a little better. I was also described as being well-known, and I thought about that, and I figure that if you stay around long enough in Washington, you become well-known. And my comments today are based on me having become well-known for my partisanship on behalf of the security of the State of Israel, as opposed to my partisanship on behalf of any one particular political party. Yes, I have voted both ways in the past. Let me say something first about the Jewish vote. First of all, it doesn't exactly earn you a profile in political courage to be pro-Israel in American politics. It is the right thing to do. It makes sense as far as our foreign policy is concerned, and so usually there's no downside. There's always been a focus on the Jewish vote, perhaps overly so. We see it all the time. A headline in a Newsweekly, "To the contenders, Jews seem to hold key to White House." My comment is halavai. We don't hold the key. The perception, however, is that we are very powerful, that we have a lot to say about who wins this office. And it is this perception, perhaps more than the reality,